Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to a brand new series. This is Prison Architect on the PC. As usual, my name is Mike, otherwise known as the Gadget Addict, and this game was gifted to me by Lady Azabat, so thank you very much for that. And I decided to give it a go here. This is a, I suppose, what would you call it? It's like a tycoon game, management sim, that kind of thing. But you're maintaining a prison. And I feel like my current intake of media at the minute is very prison-related. It seems I'm currently watching through the latest series of Orange is the New Black. I've just restarted Prison Break, and now I'm playing this. I don't know if my mind is trying to tell me something, but hey-ho. So this is the opening cutscene, just showing you everything that you got here. Garbage. I do love the art style. I think the little sprites and the dudes are just really cool looking. Prison Architect. Okay, so this is completely blind. Not played this before. I have no idea what to actually expect. The only thing I know about is that was the opening cutscene, because I had to restart. Incoming call from the CEO. This is a tough one. There's a prisoner incarcerated at the facility who's been convicted of a double murder and sentenced to death. That's where we come in. We've been contracted to construct an execution chamber in time for the guy's big day. Okay. This is where I want the new facility to be built. The first step with any project like this is to construct the building itself, with enough space inside to fit an execution room and a holding cell. Let's get started. Construct the new building here. We'll also need an entrance to the execution facility, build a large jail door on the south wall. Okay. So we want a building this size. Foundations. Oh, building brick, building concrete. We'll do a concrete building. Well, that's $60. Ah, they're both the same. Okay. Now, what do you want? Your workmen are responsible for the construction of buildings. They'll collect the steel and concrete from this storeroom and take it to the construction site. They'll use those raw materials to build the foundations and framework of your new building. This is the slowest part of construction, so you should plan ahead when building new facilities. While we take a look around, use WASD or the arrow keys to move and the mouse wheel to zoom in and out. Okay, so what's going on here? So we've got the yard, guards carrying jail keys, batons, all that kind of thing. Let's actually have a look at what prisoners. We've got March. Prisoner Zachary March, 30. So I'll call this psychologist required to show needs. Alright. Thomas Thompson. Scales, he's going to be trouble. Now Batty? Alexander. I love how it denotes their body type. Overweight, muscly, skinny. Warren Mitchell, 19. Wow, he looks like he's going to be a hell of a lot of trouble. Got the showers, got more cells down here. Where the hell's he? Headland. Pennington? One-line Derek's here. Went. Paul Russell. Okay, so we've got a few interesting prisoners here. You've seen before, we've got deliveries there. That power station. Cool. I do love the aesthetic. Oh, we've got more prisoners over here. Fuck me, that's quite a big prison, this, actually. It'd be an interesting one to keep an eye on. Kitchen. Cook's managing massive pots. Chief's office, the warden. I can sack the warden, cool. Alright, okay, how's that doing? So it requires an entrance. Okay, large jail door. $350. Control left click to make a priority. Okay. That is a big door. Okay. So the foundation is in progress. So how long until the foundation is completed? Oh, there we go. Right. Inside the building, I want a cell and an execution room. Okay, brick walls. Brick wall there. There. I'm assuming in between is going to be doors of some description. Hey, come on, guys. Speed up slightly. Alright. They don't seem to be doing this in a timely fashion. I have to go double speed to get this done. There we go. Alright, so I'm assuming this is going to be a cell, so add large data. Oh, great. You rotate an object before placement by clicking the middle mouse button or pressing R. Okay. Okay, so, second door. There we go. Speed these motherfuckers up a little bit. Just can't rely on contractors to do things at any decent speed, can you? Right, that's with two internal doors. Okay. That's looking good. Now we need to designate rooms within the spaces. Designate a cell in the smaller area where a condemned inmate will live. Right, so how do we designate? So cell. It's that one. And an execution room is that one. Do they have requirements before they become functional? Bed and toilet and electric. It's grim. Okay. So start with the toilet. No, can't put that like that. There. So we can actually use the fucker. Bed there. An electric chair. $5,000 for an electric chair. My god. Right, speed these guys up again. They're coming right. I was wondering what they were doing there for a second. Alright. So the execution chamber is ready. We just need the cell done. So let's speed up a bit faster. Come on, lads. The speed of light. Okay. No, CEO's calling again. That's essentials taken care of. There are still a few improvements you could make. It's up to you, though these aren't strictly required. It depends how much you care about your prisoners and their environment. The cell itself could be improved with an outward-facing window and a small bookshelf. And the facility would look better with higher quality floor material, like wooden floorboards or mosaic tiles. Outside, you could add some lighting and a paved pathway. Ooh, excuse me. So this fella, this is the one getting executed, is he? Edward Romsey. A teacher once, would you believe? It's not our place to decide if he deserves this. The law has made that decision. We're just here to do a job. Oh, fuck me. Sorry about that. Once you're satisfied the facility is ready, you can begin the new prisoner transfer to his cell. Simply click on the Polaroid in the cell to initiate the transfer. That's grim. Okay. Let's do some things. Let's make it nice. So we'll put a bookshelf in. And... yeah, you can have a view outside. The outside world. Right. We'll do paving stones. Yeah, to there. And then... to there. I'm not very good at this. There you go, you can go straight from the exit to your doom. And let's put some lights in. So we just put some casual lighting along the path here. And you there, and you there. And we'll stick one up there. Why not? Okay, let's speed them up a bit. That's a little... Okay, I haven't really done the lights very well. Oh my god, that looks shit. Right, what was it? Materials, we got marble tiles. Yeah, let's make it as bleak as possible. Because even marble can't make that any nicer. Right. That was really messed up, actually. Okay, right. Let's send this man to his doom. Don't shed one tear for this guy, he's a stone cold killer, guilty as charged. He even confessed. Want to hear his description of what he did? It's juicy stuff. It was around 11 PM, the lights were already on, I knew she was home. Oh shit. Oh god, we get the stories of them! Alright, what's he doing? He walks into the woman's house. Oh god almighty. That's one way of representing that. Okay. I knew I'd catch you two here. Don't. Just don't. What are you going to do? No, I'm not even going to bother doing the Susan's voice. Fucking hell. And I thought this would be a nice upbeat replacement for this war of mine. Well, that's bleak. Did he just leave the gun there? Clear as day, if you ask me. Deserves every volt he's going to get. All men deserve forgiveness, even him. Are you so sure in yourself that you can deal with such a final judgment? Catching your wife with another man is no excuse for what he did. And he went there with a loaded gun, knowing he'd find them together. That's double premeditated murder. He's done nothing but cooperate with the authorities. This state is making an example of him. If he'd committed this crime 100 miles north, he'd be looking at life imprisonment instead. How is that justice? Do you want a guy like this running free? I'll sleep just fine at night when I know he's gone. So are we going to have to then get into the moral quandaries of executing prisoners? What do you want now? Good work so far. However, there is one problem. The execution room isn't functioning yet because it doesn't have any power. Oh, well, fuck's sake. We need to connect it to the electrical supply. Oh, Christ, this is a thing. We're now viewing the prison in utilities mode, which shows us the electrical wiring layout for the entire prison. Each building in the prison is connected to the power grid by these thick underground electrical cables. Right. I assume there's so much capacity. Power is provided to the prison by this substation, which draws electricity from the grid. Okay, that makes sense. But there isn't enough power. Okay, all the lights are there. Fix this. We need to switch to utilities mode and assemble the lights are without power. Okay. Nearest electrical cables are too far away. Our engineers can't complete the wiring for this area. Extend the cables nearby to cover this wing of the prison. Okay, so utilities mode. Electrical cable. Do I have to extend it to each node, or...? That's not going to do anything while I'm still in utilities mode, is it? Or maybe because it's the middle of the fucking night and Teamsters don't work in the middle of the night. Right, okay, so he connects that to that. But I assume I must need to connect each of the rooms. Is that right? Well, we'll just wait and see what these guys do. I'm not leaving that much cable around when there's prisoners nearby. Oh no, got it. Lights aren't the only thing that needs power, your electric chair does too. Use the power. Okay. Electric chair itself is a special type of electrolyte, and it requires one dedicated power line and you need to connect up directly with the mains cables. Okay. So, utilities mode. Electrical cable. Alright, and then that's to that. Score. Alright, so we come out of utilities mode. We'll go triple time. For some reason, electricity seems to take a long time to do. And I'm assuming I'll probably have to put some extra ones in there as well anyway. Oh no, that's good. Okay, that CEO just won't leave me alone. Just text this. Alright, okay. It's gonna blow something, isn't it? Looks like we drew too much power, trip the circuit break the power station, whole prisoner's dock. I don't need more juice, and how do we do that? Switch the power station on by clicking it, then switch. Okay. Right, okay, so it's capacitors. So power station. Switch on. Right, and then utilities. Capacitors. Oh, they're expensive. Okay, so we come out of that. Speed these guys up. Because they do take their fucking sweet time to do these things. New capacitors. Okay. Well, come on. Right. Okay. And then we go down to here. Switch on. Okay, we're finished. The professional job is important in our business. Trying to worry about what happens next. Okay. Again, odd representation of that. Where the hell's this chapel? Is this something we have to go through every time someone gets executed? Can I help you? Are you looking for forgiveness? I don't know. I have to do something. I can't live with the things I've done. You have to turn yourself in. Whatever you've done, you cannot evade the consequences. You will never be able to live with yourself until you face up to your past. I want to go back. I want to forgive her. I want her to forgive me. God will forgive you no matter what you've done if you ask him to. But you must answer for your crimes in the eyes of the law. There is no other way. It is time, Edward. You have done the right thing, even though this world will not forgive you for it. You will be with God soon, and he will have the final judgment on you. I don't know how much of a comfort that actually is. God has the final judgment. What if God thinks you're a dick? That's as much as I understand about religion. Hey. Okay. This is a lot bleaker than I was expecting. Which Do I want to put like a switch on the wall or something? Apparently I did. Edward Ramsey, you've been found guilty of 2 counts of murder in the first degree. The penalty is death. Do you have anything to say? Susan, I'm sorry. Well, fuck. How can a game with little cartoon character sprites have such emotional gravitas? Chapter 2, Palermo. Uh-oh. I'd say that's a crisis. Some sort of fire in the kitchen, priorities, put it out, stop any casualties, prevent more damage. Right, emergency services. There we go. Have I done that right? I don't think I've done that right. Emergency services. Oh no, there's 2 of them coming. Apparently. Oh, there they are. Alright, right mast audio flame mounts over there. Okay. Now let's speed these guys up. We got 1 sec going to the kitchen and holy shit. Fire is fairly spreading. Right, so we're not going down at normal speed here. Well, they're having fun. Yeah, it looks like I have to keep moving them around. It did say that they'll extinguish flames that are close by. This fire out now. Well, this will be doing a fairly good job. Let's move to this one. Just use some tactical firefighting here. Right, speed up, lads, you don't move fast enough. You're walking into the fire. You bell end. Seriously, what's wrong with these guys? Okay, it looks like we've got a bit of a riot on our hands. You guys fire here. And you guys fire here. Joke's on them, they're not getting lunch today. Okay, 80 prisoners have serious complaints. 1 people have been killed recently. Oh, lovely. What the hell are you doing? What's his name? Nottenbelt. That should be the fire nearly out. apart from these two bits here. Oh Christ, I've lost two, I've killed two firemen. Shit. Come on, just get the fucking fire done. Right, okay. There's a survivor in the wreckage. Christ on a crutch, it's Don Palermo, one of the inmates. It's a mob boss. Bad news is when the budget cuts him out, we've had to sack all of our permanent doctors. Good news is the infirmary is still usable. Hire a couple of doctors and they'll take care of Don Palermo while we sort this mess out. Okay. Use the bulldoze tool to demolish the ruined canteen and kitchen. You need to remove all the debris. Right, designate a garbage zone. Right, okay, so send the fireman home. Rooms, garbage. Designate that. Staff. Two doctors. Alright, bulldoze. Bulldoze that. What do you want now? Yes, I know. I've worked out how to speed things up. Bulldoze as well. Bulldoze that. Right, speed up. Well, I've dismissed the firemen. They just seem to be hanging around. What the hell? Alright, injured fireman. Okay, so we just guess we kind of wait here until everything's gone. Ah, so you get a little percentage on everything that's going on. I have hired a couple of doctors. Oh, I have to place the doctors. Right. Whoopsie. Okay. Alright, the fireman's healed. Okay, so we've nearly got all the burnt wreckage out. And the fireman is on his way out. And that's a dead fireman. That's just disturbing. Right, come on. Off you go. You've been here for like 3 days now. Sod off. Clever lad. Okay, firemen have gone. Apart from the dead one. Don't need like a coroner or something. Alright, what does he want? Good work, let's check up on our casualty. Is this going to be like a Harvey Dent thing? Who are you? Why have you got a red face? I'm going to get a mafia drama here. I think he's trying to say something. Which of you cocksucking faggot banging rapist motherfuckers do? Mint. No one did this to you, Pappy. It was an accident. Shut your stinking mouth and listen good, the both of you. If I knew which you fuck start that fire, I'd snap your stinking neck. But my time is done, I'm going to die in this fucking bed. And there's a family business to run. The Palermo name is all we've got left. So you do the honourable thing, you dirty pieces of shit fucks. Capiche? We know what to do, Pops. Did you get a cigar in prison? Watch your fucking back. This is Nova Nico. Therefore, these inmates will be tearing the walls down within a couple of days. Gotta secure the prison before we end up with a riot on our hands. This is the deployment screen. From here, you can control... Fucking, there's deployments as well. Deploy the spread of guards to all cell blocks and rooms. Assign 10 guards to stations around the prison. That should be sufficient show of strength. Also want to patrol around the inner courtyard where we'll be building new facilities. Okay. Alright, guards. So deploy 10 guards around the prison. So... Right. Two each there. So how many is that? That's 8 of them. Holding cell. Cells there. Okay. And assign 2 guards to patrol the inner courtyard. Okay, that's there. But they're only patrolling around there. Right, so we need to repair. Okay. Hang on, I need to go back to the tactical view. Guard patrols. There we go. Right, okay. Okay, so we need to build. So build a build a kitchen approximately 12 meters square. We can't do that because we've got to build foundations first. Concrete. So I assume this is one meter square. Right, so that's 12 meters. And a canteen. Is that 20 meters square? Yeah. The same proportions. Okay. That's fine. Right, let's get this built. Then we need to designate the rooms, assign the entrance. Yes, I know it requires entrances. Right, so rooms. Kitchen. Canteen. Right, okay, maybe I need to put doors on first. Materials, objects. What are we looking for? Bins. Jail cell door. Solitary door. Where the fuck's the normal doors? Staff door. Okay. So we have a couple of doors there. Solitary doors. Okay. And rooms right now, can we assign them? Are they not finished yet? Ah. So we need to put doors in first, then we can assign what they are. That's it. Dingbat. That's kitchen, canteen. Right, so install at least 4 cookers. So cookers, 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, might as well put 5 in there. 4 fridges. What's that? Oh, to rotate. Fridges, a kitchen sink. Sink. Place a bin in the kitchen. So 4 cookers, 4 fridges, kitchen sink, bin. Connect the sink to the water mains. Hire at least 8 cooks, right? So improve the floor. Concrete, ceramic, mosaic. Metal. A ceramic floor. Why not? Have tiles in the kitchen. Right. Move on to the canteen. So install at least 2 serving tables. So put one there, one there. We'll give them 3, we'll be nice. 7 tables, install these 6 tables. So we'll have a cooker. I'm gonna have to like really change this text. I can't say shit. 4, 5, 6. And so 2 benches around each table. Bench. Okay. Glad I left room then. Ish. Alright, place a bin in the canteen. Has my bin gone? Put 4 bins in there, because, you know, cleanliness is next to godliness, isn't that what they say? Improve the canteen floor. They're not going to get marble, we'll get white tiles. Alright, okay, so let's hammer through and wait for everything to be finished. Now I'll have to connect up the utilities. Just see what they do here. They're going to be ready to riot soon, aren't they? Get the tables in, get the benches in. Okay, so we just need to wait for the benches. We can hire 8 cooks and connect the water main. Yeah, I really fucked up with the doors. Should have turned them around. Okay, hang on a second. How do you delete something? I don't know what I've just done there. I know what I need, the bulldozer. Right. So we get rid of those. Okay, so doors now. No, not rooms, objects. Doors, 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 doors. Ah, bollocks. See, I'm now just clicking things for the sake of it. Oh, fuck no, I need foundation. Shit. Is there a brick foundation that I put down there? Shit the bed. I think we have a riot on our hands here. Are they rioting? objects. Why are you putting a door in the middle of nowhere? Yeah, that's the doors there. Right, so, utilities. So that's the water supply. The large pipe on these. Right, and then I need power. So where's my power source? Yep, and then into there. Okay, stuff. Cooks. Wait till it finishes. I assume they're now getting pissed because they have no food. Are they going to kill my workmen? That's the question I want to know here. Okay, now they got the power. Do each of those needs... Oh, they all need electrical power to them. Fuck's sake. Oh, this is going to take forever. Come on. And then you... Right. Yeah, they might be losing it now. One, two, three, four. 5, 6, 7, 8. Fuck me, that took a while. At least they're eating now. You would not believe what I've just been told. Oh, what the fuck's happening now? Our guys were dumping some of the old food stuff, so they discovered a pack of narcotics and bottles of alcohol hidden in the crates. We suspected the Palermo family of smuggling into the facility for some time now, but we've never been able to determine how. Some days it doesn't just rain, it pours. Okay, well, watch this cutscene, then I'll end up. Don Victor Palermo, boss of one of the East Coast's most feared mob families. The Palermos eluded the FBI for decades. Anthony Palermo, the Don's eldest son and natural heir, ran the day-to-day operations. Nico Tamaretti wasn't a made man, but he was welcomed into the family business when he married the Don's only daughter, Vitalia. And Sonny Palermo, the Don's second son, the runt of the litter, temper like a pit bull and only half as smart. The Empire ran a narcotics trade from Maine to Florida. And that was until Anthony got caught in flagrante delicto. No shit! Shot dead by a jealous husband, it all links together. Unfortunately for the family, police at the scene found 12 kilos of uncut cocaine in Anthony's sports bag. It's generally where you keep it. And the evidence led straight to the top. That would be a warrant, I assume. Overnight, everything the Palermo family had built up crumbled to the ground. The FBI had everything they needed to ensure they'd all rot in jail. Which leaves Vitalia, the Don's daughter, the only living member of the family who isn't behind bars. We don't know much about her other than she was kept outside the family business. But somebody on the outside must have been sending those drugs in. We've got quite a serious narcotics problem on our hands here, but we can't deal with that yet. We've got our kitchen and canteen up and running, our chefs will work on preparing food for everyone, which should cool things down. I'm concerned the fire was clearly deliberate, and I don't want a repeat of that. Install a sprinkler system with a new kitchen and canteen and connect them to the water mains. All prisoners have needs. Those needs directly impact how your prisoners behave. Right now, everyone is starving hungry, and that's all everyone's been shouting about. Food is one of the highest priority needs, and you ignore it at your peril. A prisoner is just a few failed meals away from a wall-to-wall riot. You can monitor the needs of all your prisoners from the needs report. Alright, okay. Red means a lot of prisoners are angry about a particular need not being met. In this case, it's food. Possibly recreation. Food is red for virtually everyone, but these prisoners are also very bored. Prisoners in a pretty shabby state, which reflects the environment and clothing needs. Right, okay, so I need to basically fix this place up. Okay, right, so I'm going to leave us here for now. If you enjoyed this, please do leave a like and subscribe. And let me know if you want to see more of this, what I'm enjoying it so far, although obviously I'm still in the tutorial phase. But I'm quite happy to carry on playing this one. It seems like it's going to be a pretty fun game, or at the very least, very stressful. So, yeah, thank you for watching, and good night.